The second phase of the standard gauge railway has stalled because of land compensation issues. Matters of compulsory land acquisition are often emotive. But what legal framework governs compulsory land acquisition?
There are instances when you may be required to surrender your land to the government. This process is governed by the Land Acquisition Act of 1983, revised in 2010. The Act defines compulsory land acquisition as the acquisition of land by the government for a public purpose, but subject to fair and prompt compensation.
Unfortunately, as long as it is for the public benefit, the government has a right to take over your property.
Public purpose or public interest is limited to matters of regulating rights and land use in the interest of defense, public safety, public order, public morality, public health, urban planning or development and utilization.
The Constitution now guarantees your right to go to court and now put your grievances before it so that you can make a determination on whether whatever it is the government is deems as public interest is indeed public interest.
The process of compulsory land acquisition begins with a request from the acquiring body through the respective cabinet secretary or county executive member to the National Land Commission. A verification meeting is then held where the acquiring body provides a list of the affected parcels of land and the respective owners, title search details, cadastral maps of the affected area, resettlement action plan accompanied by a list of persons affected by the project. The National Land Commission then publishes a notice of intention to acquire the land and delivers a copy to the registrar and to every affected landowner. The interested parties are then examined, and the process may involve production and delivery of title documents to the National Land Commission. Upon conclusion of the inquiry, the National Land Commission makes a separate award of compensation for every person whom the Commission has determined to be interested in the land, which could either be in cash or land of a similar value.
In case you're compensated, maybe you're supposed to be compensated immediately. You end up being compensated 4 years down the line. That is not just that's not just and prompt compensation. So you can challenge that and get your land back.
If the award is not accepted, or if there is a dispute about who is entitled to compensation, the amount of compensation is paid into a special compensation account held by the National Land Commission.
Most disputes arise as a result of valuation of the property. There's also the issue of the fact that many people, the government doesn't take into consideration the ancestral value of the land. So there are people who place the fact that they did not acquire the land, they don't buy, it came down from generation to generation. They are not willing to just lease it like that. That is what now creates hurdles.
After the amount has been paid, the National Land Commission takes possession of the land after serving a notice specifying the day of possession to every interested person. The title shall then vest in the national or county government. In cases of urgency, the National Land Commission may take possession of uncultivated or pasture or arable land upon the expiration of 15 days from the date of publication of the notice of intention to acquire. Betty Kiptum, The Law.